This is Hillbilly with Rockstar's Lead Radio, and I'm talking to Battle Cross. How you doing today?
Oh, we're alive, man. We're breathing. They ain't killed us yet.
How's so far the Trespass America tour going for y'all?
Unbelievably amazing. Like, it's just, I keep on waking up every morning and expecting them to tell me to go home.
So, where are you based from?
Detroit. We're all from Michigan. All the guys are from Michigan. Most of the guys are from Detroit. I'm the only one that's an hour and a half away from Flint.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long have you all been a band?
The guitar players have been childhood friends. And then, like, about 6 years ago, they got our drummer, which started them on the right path. Mm-hmm. And then 4 years ago, they got the bass player. And 2.5 years ago, they got me.
Oh, cool. Yeah. So, what's y'all's, like, songwriting processes for your songs?
It starts with the guitars. The Tony and Huron start, they do riff soup, and then they just decide, pick and choose what they want, and then they throw the drums on it, and then Don comes in, and I wait till it's completely finished, because usually they'll change something. I'm like, you just screwed me right there.
Right.
So, I hate that.
Right. Now, how does it feel to get so many positive reviews about Pursuit of Honor?
Incredible. I don't really believe it's true. Like, I think that it's just a marketing ploy, but I guess it's real because we're here.
Right.
Yeah, we're extremely humble band, and we're from Michigan. You know, you got to be humble from Michigan nowadays.
Right. Cool. Now, Push, Pull, Destroy had over 75,000 views on YouTube.
We are just about 6 months now.
Wow. So how does that feel?
It's incredible. Like, just to see the response, and you know, the people are like, "Whoa, where'd you get that done at? That looks so cool," and it just, everything just fell into place. It's just amazing how it all happened.
Right, cool. So what's y'all's who's all, like, musical influences as a band and as you as an individual musician?
Pantera, we'll go with that. Slayer, Metallica, all the Testament is the guitar players. I enjoy a lot of Hatebreed, Deftones, we're a wide variety. You know, Hank Williams Sr.
Oh,
that's how I got my screamer on me, or my hollerer, I'd say.
Right. So, what's next after America Trespass? What are y'all doing?
We are currently in talks for our next one. We have two amazing offers on the table, and we're trying to decide which is going that. And we're doing the Mayhem Cruise. So that is coming into play with how we're being booked, because the one tour is running in the middle of it, and so we might not be able to do it just because we're doing the Mayhem Cruise. Like, I'm going on a cruise.
right, cool. So what do you see as your biggest challenges to overcome as an artist, a touring band?
Money. It's, you know, you don't want to say it, you know, because you're in it for the music, but I mean, we got a brand new truck or van, we got a brand new trailer, you know, it costs a lot to have everything, so, you know, money is tight.
Right. Yeah. So, what makes it worth it at the end, you know, even though y'all ain't, you know, got no money or whatever? So,
when people come up to you, and, like, my favorite song on the album is Caleb, and when people, like, when a father comes up to me and goes, "Yo, I listened to Caleb's, I read the lyrics for that song, and you said everything that I'm feeling." And I was, and even people that don't have kids, like, "Yo, I got a nephew, or I got a niece, or I got this, or I got that." I'm like, that song hit me. I'm just like, that is awesome to me. Mm-hmm. Like, that's just like, wow, I touched you in that way. That's cool.
Right. Describe to me your all's live performances.
High energy thrash.
Oh, really?
You might get dizzy watching me.
Cool. Well, so what would you rather be doing, in studio, or would you rather be on the stage?
I would rather be on the stage. I friggin' hate the studio.
Oh, why is that?
Because the one line that you always hear is, "You can do that better." Yeah, and then the line is, "I can do that better." So I was like, oh, God, I hate that. So by the end of the day, you do one song, you're like, I just feel like I did a whole tour.
So how did y'all come up with the name Battle Cross?
The lead guitar player, Tony, he liked it. He searched it. I know it's not cool. There's no, "Oh my God, you guys were on a sweet old trip and you guys came up with this name from the heavens." No, it kind of describes us. We're a really hardworking band and we battle it out.
Right. So, is there, like, any pre-show, like, anything y'all do to get warmed up or get hyped up or anything like that?
Not really. We say cock a lot.
Oh.
Cock.
Cock. Okay. So, like, now here on Rockstars Glued, we support like unsigned bands and all the newer bands and independent label bands. Is there any advice you give them, bands that are just now getting started and younger musicians?
Become a tech. There's more money in being a tech.
Right.
It's real hard. I mean, if you have guys in your band that don't want to work and don't want to put forth the money and put forth the effort, don't worry about saving anybody's emotions or feelings. Just cut them out.
What all sites can people find Battlecross at?
The Facebook. We have battlecrossmetal.com. Mm-hmm. We have Twitter. We have... you can go on metalblade.com and you can find us there. Facebook, Twitter, battlecrossmetal.com, metalblade.com, and that's pretty much it.
Well, Metal Blade's been around for years, since I remember. Yeah. So how does it feel to be on that label?
Yeah, it's when they said we got an offer for Metal Blade, it was like, don't look no more, let's do this.
Right.
They're like, Cannibal Corpse? Sweet. Like, Stripped, Raped, and Strangled is the reason why I growl.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like, oh yeah, that got me into the deep gutturals, and so I love that.
Cool. So now, talking about like social media, as far as Facebook, even MySpace, what's the pros and cons on all the social media sites?
Pros, you just keep people informed and in contact. They know when you're coming around. They know what's going on. The cons, sometimes you might not be able to do it all, and sometimes people might be like, "Well, why didn't you respond? Or why didn't you do this?" It's like, we're so busy that sometimes it falls through the cracks.
Right.
So that's like the only con that I can think of the social media. Mm-hmm. It's like, just, you know, you it's so up to date every minute, every second. You can do something. Somebody's got a question that they can ask you personally, and you can respond. So sometimes the only thing that I see is the problem with it is there's just not enough time in the day.
Right. So since you've been on this tour and so forth, what's the craziest moment that sticks in the back of your mind? No, it could be a fan, it could be something, whatever, craziest moment.
Oh, man. Fuckball. We played Fuckball right before we got on tour. But one of the craziest ones is in South Dakota, some dude got his face just mashed up. I have a picture of it, and on his shirt it says, "We'll fuck for beer." And he's just sitting there with his face just mangled.
Wow.
I guess he hit a girl.
He was late.
Yeah. He hit a girl, so like, I guess they crowd surfed him up, and like, he was just out.
He was a pulp.
He was pulp. It was just bloody mess.
It was like a Cabbage Patch Kid.
Yeah. Wow. Yes, a Cabbage Patch Kid with blood.
Wow. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for taking your time out to speak with us real fast. And one more last question before I let you go. What does music mean to you?
It's an escape. It's your escape. It's the way where you don't go out and blow somebody's head off. Hey, you can be whatever you want to be. You can do whatever you want. You can think however you want to think in that moment. Mm-hmm. You don't have to worry about people judging you. You don't have to. It's your music. The way you want to interpret it, the feeling. It's the way you take the music, get the emotion, and release it, and go on with your day.
Okay.
Like, there's no better feeling when you get out of the pit and you're just dead.
Right.
And you're just like, I feel beautiful. Right. And you're just a sweaty, stank mess.
Right.
Yeah, you've got a couple stinks on you, but you feel great.
All right, cool.
Well, thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.
What's up? This is Gumby from Battlecross. You are listening to Rockstars Glued Radio.
You will not deceive me. Chivalry is a 'cause I love you.